Hello students, welcome to chemistry classes. So last class we discussed the electronic configuration of simple elements. Now continuation for this class, the electronic configuration of heavier elements and what are the rules to be adopted for writing the electronic configuration of elements. So I hope all the peoples practice the electronic configuration of elements up to 30. So now for writing the electronic configuration of elements, three periodic laws or rules are used. The first one is Pauli's exclusion principle. Second one is Hoff principle. Third one is Kant's rule of maximum multiplicity. Pauli's exclusion principle states that no two electrons in an atom can have all the four set of quantum numbers identicals. So I explain in coming classes the four types of quantum numbers. One quantum numbers I already told, that is the principal quantum number n is equal to n values. So four quantum numbers, principal quantum numbers, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number and spin quantum number. These four quantum numbers have different values for an electron present in an atom. So that only explained by this Pauli's exclusion principle. No two electrons in an atom can have all the four set of quantum numbers identical. Suppose an electron present in an atom can three set of quantum numbers are having same values, but it entirely differ from the fourth set. Any one of the quantum number may differ. Second one is Hoff principles. In an atom, electrons are filled in the increasing order of energy. Electrons, Hoff means build up. Electrons are filled in the increasing order of energy. Or simply say, in a ground state, and electrons are filled in the increasing order of energies. That is Hoff principle. Kant's rule. What is Kant's rule? No pairing occurs until all the orbitals are singly occupied. No pairing occurs until all the orbitals are singly occupied. So now I explain the last two rules by simple illustrations. Listen, let us consider the atom boron, atomic number 5. How to write the electronic configuration of boron? We know that nucleus, this is some energy levels, K energy level, L energy level. K can accommodate 2 electrons, L can accommodate the remaining 3 electrons, 2 and 3. So here 1s, 2s, 2p. 1s can accommodate 2 electron, 2s can accommodate 2 electron. The remaining 1 electron is accommodated by 2p. So what is the electronic configuration of this boron? 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Symbolic representation, 2 electrons. Suppose for this 1s orbital, the 2 electrons are added. 2 electrons are represented in different spin 1, facing upwards and another one facing downwards. Suppose we two electrons in an orbital can maximum accommodate two electrons. So these two electrons are present in the particular orbital means this orbital is said to be paired orbital, paired electrons. Electrons are paired. That is a pairing occurs. Suppose 2s, two electrons, 2p, p orbital, p subshell having three orbitals. For this only one electron is present, only one electron is present. Now I consider oxygen atomic number 8, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, 2p4, 4 electrons present in the valence shell. 4 electrons present in the valence shell. How this 4 electrons are filled? This will be explained on the basis of Kant's rule. Kant's rule. No pairing occurs until all the orbitals are singly occupied. First of all, 1, 2, 3. This is co-filled configuration. This configuration is called co-filled configuration. After that only the fourth electron entering. That is the meaning. No pairing occurs until all the orbitals are co-filled or singly filled. First the three electrons are entered. Now you have arise one question. This is the way to write the electronic configuration of 2p4. Are these electrons are filled by this method? No, this is the wrong method of filling electrons. This is the wrong method of filling electrons. This electrons filling in the orbital is based on this Kant's rule. No pairing occurs until all the orbitals are singly occupied. So then the second rule, Hopper principle. Electrons are filled in the increasing order of energy. In the ground state, electrons are filled in the increasing order of energy. How this statement is applicable while writing the electronic configuration of elements? Listen, we know that the major energy levels and sub energy levels 1s, 2s, 2p. This is very, very important in the examination point of view as well as for writing the electronic configuration of elements in the multiple choice question also. 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f, 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f. First electron enter into 1s orbital. After that 2s, 2s, 1s, 2s. Then 2p. After that electron enter into 3s. 3s. After filling the 3s orbital, electrons are enter into 3p. 3p. So 3p, once electrons are filled in 3p, then goes to 4s. After filling 4s only, electron enter into 3d. So once again I repeat this topic in a simple manner. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f, 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f. First electron filled in the 1s orbital, then 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3p, after that 4s. This is very, very important. 3p, after that electron enter into 4s. After filling 4s only, electron moves to 3D. After filling, porous only electron moves to 3D orbital. So one example for this. Zinc, atomic number 30. Zinc, atomic number 30. How to write the complete electronic configuration based on this alpha principle? You remember, first, before that, you must know how many electrons maximum accommodate in each subshell. First, s orbital can accommodate 2 electrons, p orbital can accommodate 6 electrons, d orbital can accommodate 10 electrons. First electron enter into 1s2, then 2s2, 2p6, count that, totally 10 electrons are filled. After filling 2p, electrons moves to 3s, 3s2, 3p6, 3p6, 3p is completed, then electron enter into 4s2. Now count the electrons, 10, 18 and plus 2 electron, 20. How many electrons remains? 10 electron. All the 10 electrons then enter into 3D10. This is the electronic configuration of this zinc. Some elements source, we are expecting one type of electronic configuration, but the actual electronic configuration of element is entirely differ. Actual electronic configuration is differ. How to identify certain such type of elements? For your considerations, now I explain two elements. First one is copper, atomic number 29. What is the expected configuration? The expected configuration is like that only. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2 and 3d9. The d orbitals, before that you must know the orbitals with co-filled configuration and completely filled configurations are more stable than partially filled configuration. What is co-filled configuration? So p orbital can accommodate 3 electron means it is co-filled. D orbital can accommodate 5 electron means it is co-filled. Co-filled configuration. This is co-filled configuration P3 and D5. What is completely filled? P6, D10, S2. Completely filled configuration. Completely filled configuration. Why these configurations are more stable? Co-filled and completely filled configurations are more stable due to their symmetrical arrangement. Symmetrical arrangement of this electron present in the concerned orbitals. Therefore, these orbitals are more stable. For the stability of copper atom, exchange of electrons takes place. How this exchange takes place? Exchange of electrons. One of the s electron goes to the d orbital. So now actual configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d10. So wherever you are asking what is the electronic configuration of copper means, simply write configuration of argon is a inert gas configuration, atomic number 18, 3d10, porous 1, or configuration of argon 3d porous 1, 3d10, porous 1, 3d10. In the similar way, chromium atomic number 24. Chromium atomic number 24. What is the expected configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. 3s2, 3p6. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. How much electrons are filled? 18. Then after filling 3p, electron moves to porous. Porous 2. 3d4, 24 is filled. Here also the d4 configuration. What is the nature of the d4 configuration? 1, 2, 3, 4. Only one electrons necessary for co-filled configuration. Only one electron necessary for co-filled configuration. So this electron, suppose this chromium attain only one electron, means it becomes co-filled configuration. Co-filled configuration is more stable than this partially filled configuration. Hence one electron of porous orbital transferred to 3d subshell. Therefore the actual configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, porous 1, 3d5, porous 1, 3d5. So this is the electronic configuration of some exceptional cases. So now I hope all the people thoroughly understand the electronic configuration of the symbol elements, especially atomic number 30. So in this class you must learn the three rules, Pauli's exclusion principles, the periodic rules, Pauli's exclusion principle, Hopf principle, and Kant's rule of maximum multiplicity, and or electron represent electron addition in their orbitals by this pictorial representation. You remember this pictorial representation while writing this electronic configuration of any elements. Now you practice the electronic configuration of elements up to atomic number Z is equal to 56. Z is equal to 56. So first class the atomic number Z is equal to 30, the second class this atomic number Z is equal to 56. So practice very well. If you have any doubts, you may ask. Thank you.